2017 was a very warm year for the world as a whole and for Australia. This occurred despite the absence of an El Niño, which is normally associated with our warmest global temperatures. While Australia did experience chilly winter nights in the south, several heavy rainfall events and Tropical Cyclone Debbie, the year was dominated by extended warm periods. Temperatures were well above average across eastern Australia from the start of the year into late summer, with record warm days and nights for large parts of New South Wales and southern Queensland. On the other side of the country, a sequence of slow-moving tropical lows in late January and early February brought record rain across the Top End, the Kimberley, and much of the west of Western Australia. Towards the end of March, severe Tropical Cyclone Debbie delivered torrential rainfall to Queensland and northern New South Wales, causing flooding from Bowen to Lismore. Flooding continued into early April in some rivers. Winter to early spring was unusually dry for Southeast Australia, particularly June. It was Australia's second driest June on record and the driest on record for Victoria. This was associated with unusually high atmospheric pressure across the middle of Australia and fewer rain-bearing systems crossing the southern states. Clear skies and sunny days during winter were accompanied by frosty nights in the southeast. June nights were particularly chilly over parts of southern inland New South Wales and northern Victoria. Further north, daytime temperatures for July were exceptionally warm. The mean maximum temperature for July was the warmest on record for Queensland, the Northern Territory, and Western Australia. The dry and warm conditions continued into September for much of the country. It was the driest September on record for New South Wales and the Murray-Darling Basin. High temperature records were set in September for Victoria, New South Wales, and Queensland. Coupled with the dry conditions in previous months, this led to extreme fire danger in some areas. In October, heavy rains associated with surface troughs affected eastern Queensland and northeastern New South Wales, with flooding around Bundaberg. It was the second wettest October on record for Queensland. After a cool start to November, when frost damaged crops in western Victoria, an extended period of very warm weather affected Victoria and Tasmania, thanks to northerly winds driven by a strong, long-lived blocking high over the Tasman Sea. This exceptional warm spell was brought to a dramatic end by heavy rainfall, which caused some flooding in northern Victoria at the start of December. There were no clear El Niño or La Niña patterns during much of 2017. But following steady cooling of the tropical Pacific Ocean, the Bureau declared a La Niña at the start of December. In the end, 2017 was another warm year, with rainfall somewhat above average overall. Temperatures in Australia have increased by around a degree since the middle of last century, making warmer than average years that much more likely. 2017 certainly fits that pattern, as it was our third warmest year on record. From the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Lyndon Ashcroft.